How's it going, everybody? Welcome back, and a quick step-by-step guide to show you how you can use NordVPN, a very basic guide. If you're new to VPNs, this is how you can use it. Obviously, you can just hit the quick connect button and it will connect you to the nearest server. I don't like to use that because I'm a bit more particular with my VPN use. Usually I like to unblock Hulu, so I'll just click the New York server and that's pretty much it. So you can just zoom into the map, click whatever location you're trying to connect to. You can also search whatever server you're trying to connect to here as well, or location. You can scroll down, or you can even connect manually to these servers. Let's just select Atlanta, and you can see all the Atlanta servers right here and the percentage of how loaded they are. So if you go all the way down to the bottom, this is how they're sorted. They're just sorted by load. So pretty cool feature. Just wanted to point it out real quick. Now you basically know how to use the VPN, but you definitely want to learn about the features to use it to the, well, max out the potential of your VPN. First of all, you have specialty servers such as double VPN, which will connect you to two servers rather than one for double security. You have onion or VPN, which will give you the anonymity of the Tor browser as well as the encryption of the VPN all in one server, and peer-to-peer for peer-to-peer specialty activities. You have meshnet right here, which will allow you to share files over encrypted connections with selected emails. Just type in the person's email that you want to share your file with, and you'll be able to invite them. And you have threat protection, which will block malware-ridden websites, avoid malicious ads, stop web tracking, and protect your device from infected files before they damage your device as you download files, And if we go to the auto connect right here, NordLynx is definitely the fastest protocol. You wanna always use NordLynx. It probably makes NordVPN arguably the fastest VPN in the industry. And you have the kill switch, which will disable your internet connection when the VPN disconnects unexpectedly, and the app kill switch will close selected apps when you disconnect from the VPN or the connection drops unexpectedly, rather than disconnecting your entire connection as it is with the conventional or regular kill switch. Split tiling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not, so this is a very useful feature. Custom DNS for an easy way to change your DNS and obfuscated servers if you're in a censorship heavy country. Overall, NordVPN is a very well-rounded VPN that is pretty cheap for the performance and quality that it offers. And if you're interested in learning more about a NordVPN or even saving a little bit more, you'll find links to the special discounts and the full review if you'd like to learn more about the privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. Besides that, comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.